इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल?
यस सर।
ओके, यूजिंग सोर्स ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन दिस इज एग्जाम्पल फोर। यूजिंग सोर्स ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फाइंड द करंट आई। यूजिंग सोर्स ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फाइंड द करंट आई इन सर्किट शॉर्ट। In circuit shown, so circuit given is amps, 60 ohms, 30 ohm, this is 12 ohm, and this is 22 ohm, sorry, 22 amps. So this is the circuit given, and we have a dependent source, which is 5i. And this I is the current through 30 ohms. And this I is the current through 30 ohms. Now, what type of dependent source is this?
Current controlled voltage source.
Yes, it is current controlled voltage source. The rhombus contains plus and minus, so it is voltage source. The controlling parameter is current, so therefore it is a current controlled voltage source. Now, in this circuit, I need to transform the sources, then find the value of current I. And in the source transformation, you should remember one thing, that only the independent sources can be transformed. Dependent sources, we don't transform. Okay? We don't transform dependent sources. Dependent sources are to be kept as it is. Okay? So one note you can take. Dependent sources are retained in the circuit without transformation. Okay, because I will not be knowing exact value of this dependent source, hence I cannot transform it. So it should be kept as it is. Then remaining two sources I can transform. 2 ampere 60 ohm can be transformed into voltage source. 22 amps 12 ohms can also be transformed into voltage source. Okay, so here you can take a point. Transform both current sources into voltage source. Transform both current sources into voltage source. So I will be keeping my dependent source as it is. This is 12 ohms, 5i, 30 ohm. This is the current I. Now, let this be V1 and let this be V2. So, V1 is equals to current multiplied by resistance, 2 amps into 60 ohms. So, that is 120 volts. V2 is equals to 22 amps into 12 ohms. So this is a 220 plus 44, 264 volts. Okay. So the direction of 2 amps is downwards. Therefore, V1 will be with a negative sign up and positive sign down. Direction of 22 amps is also downward. V2 is with negative sign up and positive sign down. So now I have, this is 120 volts and this is 264 volts. Now I should find I. Okay. I should find this I. Now if I knew all the voltages and all the currents in the circuit, I would have done directly, what we can say. I would have directly found out by taking a simple Ohm's law. But here, since this source value is not known, the dependent source value is not known here. It is phi I, which is dependent on this current, which we are finding out. So therefore, what we can do is, I can apply KVL to this loop. Okay. So to this loop with a current I, I will apply KVL. So to find I, apply KVL to the loop or to the circuit. So when we want to apply KVL, then we need to mark the polarities. The polarities of 120 volts, 264 volt and 5i volts is already known. Only thing I need to know is the polarity of 30 ohm drop, 12 ohm drop and 60 ohm drop. Now the direction of current I is already mentioned in the example. I need not to assume it. The direction I is already mentioned in the example and it is clockwise. So with respect to this direction, the point where the current is entering is always higher potential point, and the point where current is leaving is always the lower potential point. In any passive element, current enters at higher potential point, exit at lower potential point. So in any passive element, the terminal of the element into which the current is entering is always positive, okay, and the terminal of the element where the current is leaving from is always negative. So therefore here current I is entering 30 ohm at this terminal, so this terminal is positive and the other terminal of 30 ohm is negative. So upper terminal of 12 ohm, the current is entering into the upper terminal of 12 ohm, therefore this becomes positive, the other terminal become negative, the current flows in this loop and enters the lower terminal of 60 ohm, which becomes positive, and exit from upper terminal of 60 ohm, which become negative. Now when I have the polarities marked, it is very simple to write the KVL equation. Now it depends how you consider the potential, whether you consider fall of potential as positive or fall of potential as negative. It depends when we write the equation. But in whichever way you may consider, my KVL equation will remain same because we are applying the same concept for each element. Okay. So how did you follow so far? Did you take fall in potential positive or negative? Anybody? If a element is traced from positive terminal to negative terminal, did you take this drop of 30 ohms as positive or negative? I think you took negative.
Negative,
Yes, more
sir.
important value is negative
Sir,
generally.
negative.
Okay, so what is a small note what I will write here is take. Now this again we will see in detail when we look into loop analysis, KVL. Okay, take fall in potential. A fall in potential can be across resistor, across capacitor, across inductor, across voltage source, whatever. Okay, take fall in potential negative. And rise in potential positive. Rise in potential, fall in potential means what? Positive sign indicate higher potential point, negative sign indicate lower potential point. If I am tracing or if I am traveling or tracing the element from positive terminal to negative terminal of it, then it is a fall in potential. From higher potential point, I am going towards lower potential point. So the current I is flowing from higher potential point to lower potential point. Hence, all the voltage drops are taken to be negative. Okay? And what about voltage sources? It depends on their polarity. Now start applying this KVL. Apply a KVL. Let me name the terminals A, B, C, D. Now apply KVL to the circuit A, B, C, D, A. This is a loop. Okay. Now starting from A, you apply KVL. Okay. B, C, D and back to Now, starting from A, phi I is a voltage source. So the value of this source is phi I volts, and this is a voltage source. When I am tracing this element from A, I am getting rise in potential because it is negative terminal point to positive terminal point. It is a rise in potential. So this comes out to be plus phi I. Next, what about 30 ohm? Drop across 30 ohm. The potential difference across 30 ohm is 30 I. I is the current, 30 is the resistance, so drop is 30 I. What is the polarity? Should I take negative or positive?
Negative.
Negative. Okay,
Negative,
minus 30 I. Coming to 12 ohms, minus 12 I. Because again it is a fall in potential. 264 volts. I am tracing this 264 volt source from negative terminal to positive terminal. So this it should be plus 264, 120 volts. Now V1 is traced from positive to negative, higher to lower. That is, there is a fall in potential. If you face positive sign, take a negative sign. If you face negative sign, take positive sign. That's it. Minus 120, minus 60 into I is equals to 0. Now in this whole equation, there is only I which is unknown. Is it? I have one equation and one unknown. I can very easily find the value. So 5I minus 30I minus 12I minus 42. 25 minus 12 minus 37 and minus 60 minus 97 I. Is it right? 264 minus 120. That is 144 is equals to minus 144. So value of I is equals to
1.48.
one second. Direction of I is equals to 144 by 97. Yes, value is
1.48.
1.48. Yeah. So the value of current is 1.48 amperes. So once I know the value of I can get what is the value of source value of this voltage. Now if I changes, source value of this source changes. Okay. So this is one example on source transformation. Next, we'll look into source shifting. Source shifting example. Using source shifting and source transformation, find the value of voltage Vx. This is example 5. Using source shifting and source transformation, find Vx. Okay. So a circuit and these examples, whatever I'm solving, these are from previous year question papers. Okay, most of the examples what I'm solving are from previous year question papers. And please don't expect me to mention which year it has come. I can't go to that micro level like it was done in your 12th standard classes. And please collect your previous year question papers and keep with you. 2 ohms. 4 minus this is 4 volts. Okay. Yeah. Now this is the circuit shown. To this circuit, I have to find Vx. Sorry, this is 6 ohms. Okay. So finding the value of voltage Vx means what? Finding the voltage across a 6 ohm. So in my entire transformation, I should not touch this 6 ohm. My 6 ohm should be retained in the last step of the example solution. Okay. So I should find the value voltage Vx. Now this Vx should also should not get consumed in the transformation. Because after transformation, certain nodes will get consumed, or certain nodes will get eliminated, or certain branches will get eliminated. But one thing we should make sure that this node Vx and the element 6 ohm should not be consumed or eliminated in the process of simplification. So this Vx and 6 ohm should be retained as it is, okay, as they are. Now, using source shifting, source transformation as of now not possible, because 4 volts is an independent ideal voltage source wherein nothing is in series with it directly. 2 ohm and 2 ohm are there, but there is a node here, so those will not come in series with 4 ohm. So at first step, transformation is not possible. So at first step, source shifting has to be done. So what is the principle of source shifting? We have seen it in the previous class. This is the source shifting. This was a voltage source we had, which we shifted beyond the node N1 in the same direction, and later we shifted beyond the node N2 in the same direction. Okay, so we should be following this principle of source shifting here. So observe, let me name the node. Let it be node A, okay, and let this be node B, and let this be node X. Because the voltage is Vx, I will call the node as X. So there are three nodes. Let this be C. Now, the possibility of source shifting is there only at node A and node B. Node C is not connected to 4 volts directly, so it is out of question. Now, should I push this 4 volt beyond node A, or should I push this beyond node B? That is the question. Because both possibilities will work. I can push the source beyond the node ahead, or I can push the source beyond the node which is previous to the source. Okay, or on both the sides I can do that. But one thing we should remember is, if I put this source 4 volts beyond node B, in a 2 ohm and 6 ohm branch, then 6 ohm will come in series with 4 volts, and it has to be transformed in the later stage. But like I told, this Vx and 6 ohm should be kept intact as they are. I should not touch this part of the circuit. So I will not push this 4 volt source beyond node B, but instead I will push this source beyond node A. Okay, so you can add a node shift 4 volt source beyond node A. So when I shift this beyond node A, I should observe that 4 volt terminal of this 4 ohm resistor is positive, terminal of 2 ohm resistor towards left, they are positive. So the direction of 4 volt is upward, in the same direction I should be pushing them. Okay, so once I do that, I'll be getting the circuit like this. So this is my Vx and this is my 6 ohm. This is this 2 ohms. This is 2 ohms connected to Vx. This is 2 ohms connected to node A. This is 4 ohms connected to node A. So this should be positive. This should be positive because these two are positive here. Hence, my polarity of the source should be this direction. 4 volts, 4 volts. And this branch from A to B has to be made the voltage effectively zero. So to make the voltage zero for an voltage source, it should be replaced by short circuit. So this is A and this is B, this is C. Okay. And observe, from A to B, it is the same source. It is the same connection. From A to B, it is the same connection. There is no change from A to B. So what I will do, I will simply redraw the circuit this way. This is 4 volt, 4 ohm, this circuit. Okay. This is 4 volt, 2 ohms. Okay, this is this tone. This is node C. This is VX. Okay. So this is B and this is A. Okay. Sorry, this. This is 6 ohm and this is 2 ohm connected to VX. This is the 2 ohm connected to C. This 2 ohm which is connected to C in series with 4 volt, 4 ohm in series with 4 volt. So just I have slightly changed the orientation. Now observe, this 4 volt 2 ohm can be converted to current source. This 4 volt 4 ohm can be converted to current source. So first I will draw the original circuit as it is. This is VX. This is 6 ohm and this is 2 ohm. This is node C. This inner circuit. Now 4 volt 2 ohms can be converted to a current source. This is 2 ohm resistor in series with 4 volt and a current source here. Let this be I1. The direction of 4 volt is upward, so the direction of arrow marking current source is also upward. Okay. Now I have one more voltage source with 4 volt and 4 ohm. Okay. This is 4 ohm. Let this be I2. And this direction of 4 volt is again upward. So I2 is upward. Now see, this voltage source 4 volt 4 ohm is not connected to C here, it is connected to X, node X, that is VX. So this has to be connected to the node X. This has to be connected to node X. Okay. Now, I should find out what is. I1 and I2. So I1 is 4 volt 2 ohms. That is 4 volt by 2 ohm, which is 2 amperes. I2, 4 volt by 4 ohm, 1 ampere. So this is 1 ampere and this is 2 ampere. Okay. So now I can have the parallel combination of these 2 ohm, 2 ohm resistor in series with this 2 ohm resistor. Okay. I can have that combination. So I can have this parallel combination of 2 ohm and 2 ohm resistor. Okay. I will draw here. So I will take this 2 ohm and this 2 ohm 2 parallel 2 is equals to 1 ohms. Now I will replace this circuit by 1 ohm. Okay, 2 ampere in parallel with 1 ohm. Okay. So this sorry. So this is 4 ohms. Okay, this 1 amp and 4 ohm will remain as it is. Now this 2 amps current source. And parallel combination of 2 ohm and 2 ohm will give us 1 ohm. Now this is terminal C. This is again 2 ohms, which is connected to VX. This is 6 ohm, and this combination is connected to directly VX. Okay. Now, taking the combination of 1 ohm, 2 ohm, and 6 ohm is difficult here because 6 ohm should not be taken out. It should not be consumed in any simplification. Now, time being, I will convert these 2 amps, 1 ohm into a voltage source. Okay. And I will take that 1 ohm and 2 ohm in series. Then again, we'll see what will happen. Okay. So here you can write, convert 2 amps, 1 ohm to voltage source. Convert 2 amp 1 ohm to voltage source. So this 1 amp 4 ohm will remain as it is. This is 1 ohm of this 2 ampere source, and here let this be V dash. Okay. And the direction of 2 amps is upward, therefore, positive terminal will be upward, negative terminal will be downward. This is terminal C. This is 2 ohm. This is 6 ohm and this is Vx. Okay. So V dash is, it is 2 amps into 1 ohms, which is 2 volts. So this is 2 volts. Now you can see this 1 ohm and these 2 ohms have come in series. Okay. So I will take the series combination of this. This is 1 amps and 4 ohms as it is. Now here I will get a resistance of 3 ohms and a voltage source of 2 volts. So directly connected to Vx. And this is also connected to Vx. Now observe, 2 volt 3 ohm is also connected to this node X, 4 ohms is connected to node X, 1 amps is connected to node X. So all these connections are in parallel. Okay. I will redraw this. This is 6 ohm, which is Vx. Now all are connected to the same terminal. Okay. So I will redraw this like this. This is 4 ohms. This is 1 amps. This is 3 ohms and this is 2 volts. Okay. Now, if I convert 1 amps 4 ohm into voltage source, 2 voltage source will come in parallel. Okay. So it is better to convert 2 volt 3 amps into a current source. Okay. So we can take convert 3 volt 2 ohms into current source. Okay. So what I get here is this 4 ohm 1 amps will remain as it is. Now I will get one more current source in parallel with the resistance 3 ohms, and this is Vx, this is 6 ohms. Okay. Now this is 1 amperes and 4 ohms, this is 3 ohms, and this 2 volt source is having direction upward, so the direction of current in this source will be upward, and the current here is 2 volt divided by 3 ohms. Let this be I dash. So I dash is equals to 2 volt by 3 ohms is equals to 0.667 okay, amperes we can take. Amperes. Okay. Now take the total current. Current 1 ampere is also upward. Current I dash is also upward. Okay. So there are, I can take the effective value. I can take the effective value of 1 amp and 0.667 amps. So this will give us a single source. The direction of 1 amps is also upward. I dash, that is 0.667, is also upward. So this will be 1.667 in parallel with R. In parallel with 6 ohms. So what is R here? R is equals to 4 parallel 3. So this 4 ohms and this 3 ohms are in parallel. So equals to 4 into 3 divided by 4 plus 3. So R is equals to what I get? 12 by 7, which is 1.71 ohms. Around we will get same 12/7, 1.714, yeah, 1.71 ohms. Okay, so this is 1.71 ohms. Now, how to find Vx? Now, Vx is the voltage across 6 ohm. You can use a branch current formula and find the current through 6 ohm and find what is Vx. So here Vx is equals to, so let this be a current I. So Vx is equals to I into 6 ohms. So what is I? I is equals to, I can write branch using branch current formula, 1.667 into opposite branch of I, that is 1.71 ohms, divided by total resistance 1.71 plus 6. So this will come out to be, is anybody, 1.71 divided by 7.71 into 1.667. It is 0.369 or 0.37. The current I is 0.369 amperes. Therefore, Vx is equals to 0.369 into 6. That will come out to be 2.21 volts. Okay, so Vx is 2.21 volts. So this is the solution. Okay, now it takes this much time to come to solution. Right? Any doubts so far?
No, sir.
Yes, any doubts so far? Others?
No, sir.
Then you take a quiz question.
No, sir.
So, in the circuit shown using source transformation and source shifting, okay, find the current through 4 ohms. Using source transformation and source shifting, find current through 4 ohms. where voltage value is 3x volts, x is your USL. And you have lab today?
No, sir.
No. Okay. Submit by. I will be creating an assignment this in the Google Classroom. You have to answer that assignment. Submit by around 2:30 p.m. Okay, you will be free by 1 o'clock, and you have got 2 and 1.5 hours to solve. Okay.
So we have classes till 2:40, sir.
Fifth hour you have class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
2:40. Okay, then submit by 3:30. Okay, only one example, no issues. 3:30 or okay, you submit it by 4 o'clock. Okay. Submit it by 4:01 p.m. At exactly 4:01 p.m., I will delink the question. You cannot submit after that. So, any doubts? Any questions?
No, sir.
If not, then shall we call for the day?
Yes, sir.
Yes, anybody else? Any questions? If no questions, then